Hey guys, welcome to the Dress My Craft YouTube channel. Design team member Kanika Jain this side, and in this video I shall be talking about the Transforme sheets by Dress My Craft, and these are the two projects which I'll be making in the video. But before moving forward, make sure you click on the subscribe button and as well turn the bell notification also, you're all updated. So let's get started. So that's how Transforme sheet looks like, and they have got various designs, so you can check out the description box, I have linked to them, and how to use and everything is mentioned on the back side. And this is how the Transforme sheet looks like, and these are the mirror images so that when you transfer they look perfect. Here's another theme which is Vintage Queen, and you can see a lot of elements in one sheet only. And that's the vintage tiles, so these are perfect for your coasters as well. And you can see I have used some of them, as I'll be showing some of the inspirations to you in this video as well. So these sheets are right now available in A4 size, and here you can see Dream Door. So this is coordinating to their latest paper pack which they launched, which was Dream Door. Here you can see my Dress My Craft Teflon Bone folder, and on the back side I added this Transforme image. That's one of my altered glass bottle, and for this I used Baby Giggles Transforme sheet. And here you can see I made a home decor piece, that's the hanging, and on this as well I used Transforme, and that's the paperweight. And I did Transforme on an acrylic block. So you can see the versatility of the Transforme sheets. You can use them on any surface. So now let's get started. So here I'm using Vintage Tiles #4, and I'll be using this one motif. So all the links I have mentioned in the description box, so you can check that out as well. So first of all, to start with Transforme sheets is that you need to fussy cut the element which you want to transfer. So here I am taking a wooden coaster which I have already colored, and I'll be fussy cutting this motif using my fussy cutting scissors. So for coloring the MDF base, I have used chalk paints. I have worked with chalk paints and Transforme, and I feel they work best. Now here you can see I'm going little intricate, and that's how you need to cut to make sure that the element which get transferred looks real, and how intricate you go is like how perfect your Transforme would look. So here you can see I'm done with fussy cutting. So the first step is to take a bowl of water, and the first thing you need to do is make sure you take out the top film, which is this transparent film. So you need to remove this film, and you need to hold your element. So here I'm using the Dress My Craft ceramic tip tweezer, and then I'm putting the element upside down in water for about 10 to 12 seconds. Make sure you count 10 to 12 seconds and do not exceed that. And once you keep the motif in water, you will see that the sheet has curled up. So now I'll be simply placing it upside down on the base like this, and I'll just let it get settled for about a second or two, and with a dry and clean brush I'll be just simply doing this, and then I'll simply slide it down, and you can see how satisfying it is to do and how crisp the image you have got. So now I'm simply removing the bubbles and making sure that the element is stuck very well. And once done, this is how it looks. Can you see how beautiful this looks? Now to add little more embellishment, here I'm using a script stamp and using my archival ink. While using any ink, make sure you're using pigment and permanent ink. And I'm randomly stamping it on the borders. So the reason you need to make sure you are using a pigment or a permanent ink is that after you are done with this, you need to make sure that you are sealing this. So to varnish, you need to make sure that you are using a permanent ink, otherwise your dye based ink will get mixed up and will create a mess. And And that's how a coaster looks like. It was very easy to create one. So like this, here I'm again using the Dream Door Transforme sheet, and I'll be using this particular motif, which is this butterfly, and we will be creating a fridge magnet. So first of all, again, I'm going to simply fussy cut my element. These Transforme sheets have made our work very easy, especially for home decor or if you want to embellish anything. As well, I just embellished my Easy Cuts die cutting machine as well. So you can see the versatility of these Transforme sheets, and they are amazing. And you must give your hands a try on them at least once, and I'm sure you will love it. So once you are done fussy cutting, this is how my butterfly looks like. Here I have the fridge magnet, which I have already colored using the chalk paints. And here I am again repeating the same process, which is taking the transparent film out. Using my tweezers, I'll be holding up my element and then keeping it in water for about 10 to 12 seconds. And this time I'll be showing that what if you are not able to remove your backing from the motif at the one go. So that's how I am just removing the transparent film, and now using my tweezers I'll be holding up my element and then keeping it in water. And now simply I'm going to place it over the base like this with the help of my brush. That's the dry and clean brush. So I'm just removing the backing, and if you see here, I am not able to remove. That is because I didn't keep my element properly in time. So for that, you need to just spread water little bit, and there you go. And you can see how easily now I'm able to remove the backing, and I have got the crisp image again. Now to complete this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a stamp image so that my fridge magnet looks complete. So on my acrylic block here, I have taken up the stamp, and I'm using a black permanent ink. And now I'm simply going to stamp the sentiment to make my fridge magnet look complete. And here you can see how beautiful this looks now. Now let's move on to the next part and see how you can seal these Transforme sheets. So for that, I'll be using a varnish, and the varnish which I found the best is this Cadence Aqua Stone varnish. And here I'm taking up my non-stick craft mat from Dress My Craft, and I'm pouring in this varnish. And now I'll be using a flat brush, and I'm going to just apply varnish. So what I'm going to do is, from the center of the element, I'm going to come outside like this. Similarly, I'm going to cover the Transforme element first, making sure that it gets permanently stuck, and then I'm going to simply apply the horizontal or vertical strokes. Just make sure you're applying good amount of varnish so that your base is sealed properly. And as well, once this layer is dried, here after 2 hours I'm applying a second coat of varnish. So this time I directly poured the varnish on my base itself, as on the base it already has varnish, so I can do that. Once done, I'll just leave them to dry, and that's how these Transforme sheets work. And I'm sure you liked the video, so make sure you're trying your hands on these amazing Transforme sheets, and these are a must have and a must try on. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to see you soon again next time. Till then, happy crafting.